This is the University of St. LaSalle College of Arts and Sciences Mathematics Department, and this is our third of our video series of Algebra 101, and this is the second video of our functions topics. So today's selected topic is all about representing functions. Okay, so we have talked about functions last video. We talked about the definitions of a relation, domain, range, and of course the function itself. But I forgot to tell you there that there are different ways of representing functions. What we have emphasized in that video is only these, the set of ordered pairs, which is pretty much known to you guys right now. So we have f, that's the name of the set. So we have 1 1 3 5 4 6. So this is one way and a common way of representing functions. We can also represent functions via equations, which will look like this. So we have f of x equals x squared plus 1. So this f of x denotes that this is in functional notation. We're going to talk about that in the next video, or the next series of videos. We could also represent functions in a graph. So if we have a graph, a Cartesian plane, you know, the one with the x and y axis, and we are going to sketch something in there in that graph, that could also be a function. But we will be knowing if it's a function or not in the next slides. And we could also represent functions in a table of values, so like this one. Anyways, this table of values is just a fancier way of writing sets. So you could put instead of 1 1, you could put 120, 230, 340, and it would look like this. Okay, only that this table of values will look like it's in a tabular form, of course, rather than this mathematical notation of sets. So they are really one of the same anyways. Okay, so we're going to determine whether the relation is a function or not. So given those different representations that we have last slides, so we're going to determine if this is a function or not. First up, you know this already, so this is a set. So again, the definition of a function is that every input value will give us one unique output value. So is 1 only giving us a 4? Well, pretty much, there's no 1 there. Is 2 only giving us a 4? Well, yes, there's no other 2 in the domain. And 3 only gives us 5. So there, this number 1 is indeed, yes, it's a function. Don't confuse yourself with a range here. It has both 4, and it's okay, because the thing is, it just so happened that 1 gives us 4, and 2 also gives us 4, and that's just fine. The only restriction for it to be a function is that one element of the domain gives us two elements of the range. So that is really a not good thing for functions, because it will not be a function. Okay, number 2. So we are given an equation. So how can we check on this? First, we need to try to input a lot of values of x and try if we're going to input x's, will it give us two values of y's? Okay, so in these equations, notice if we go on through algebra, we will see this most of the time, rather than sets, rather than graphs, rather than table of values. We will see sets all of the time. So we need to know if it's a function or not. So imagine this x. If we're going to put, say, for example, 1, what will be the y value? What will be the output value if we're going to input 1? So imagine 1 times 2 is 2. It's only giving us 2. Right, so there's no more answer that if we're going to multiply 2 by 1, it will give me a different one. So it's only going to be 2. So imagine x, if x is equal to 2 this time. Okay, so if x is equal to 2, 2 times 2 is 4. And there's no more answer for that. Okay, if I'm going to use 3, it will only be 6. If I'm going to use plug in 4, it will only give me 8, and so on and so forth. So you can check and verify all the possible numbers out there, all the real numbers, if you can remember our first video. Input all the real numbers, and you will see that the y values will always be a unique one. Okay, it's always going to be a unique one. So therefore, this equation, y equals 2x, is going to be, yes, it's a function. Anyways, this x, remember our definitions last video? X's are all the parts of the domain, so we input here. Y is our outputs, our the value of our range. So we wait for the output there after putting an input. Okay, next is we're given these. Well, I forgot to say this in the slide before. This is a diagram. Okay, so this is a diagram. So we could also you could also represent function using a diagram. So what is this? Imagine this first oval. This will be your first component. Your second oval is your second component, and might as well this is the domain, and this is the range. Okay. Now, we will try to see that -2 gives us 4. Okay. And that's it. You can imagine it in a set. So -2 to 4. That's it. -1 gives us 1. Okay. 0 gives us 0. 1 gives us 1. 2 also gives us 2. So the question is this a function? Do every element in the domain give us a unique output in the range? Yes or no? Well, pretty much yes. Okay, so again, -2 only gives us 4 and nothing else. Okay, 0, let me go back here, sorry. A 0 gives us only 0, nothing else. 1 gives us 1. Okay, 2 gives us 4 only. Now, don't get confused because 4 gives us -2 and 2. Well, that's not the right direction. This is the range. So, these are the outputs. Okay, so from the inputs, we're going to look at it from left to right, not right to left. That's going to be totally wrong. So, this is a function. So, this is displaying a many-to-one correspondence. Okay, so it's a yes, it's a function. Now, one more thing. So for number 4, we'll be given a graph. Okay, now this is the thing that I've mentioned a while ago. How can we determine if a graph is a function? Okay, how can we determine? Oh, well, if you're going to do it in an abstract way, you need to convert this into an equation and then check the equation if it's a function, if it's, you know, the way that the one that we did with number 2. But then that will be a very tasky thing to do. Good thing someone invented this. So this is the vertical line test. What does it say? So the vertical line test is a very simple test to know if graphs are functions or not. So every time we're given a graph of a function, we use the vertical line test to determine whether it represents a function. Okay, a graph is a function, listen, if and only if no vertical line intersects the graph in more than one point. Again, if and only if no vertical line intersects the graph in more than one point. So, well, how can we illustrate this? Now, going back with our graph, we will try to see and imagine a vertical line here, an imaginary vertical line. And then that vertical line should only intersect with our graph once. Okay, only once, if and only if it intersects once. The moment it intersects twice with our graph, it's not a function. I hope you're getting me. So for example, I'm going to imagine a vertical line here. So, well, pretty much it only intersects with our graph once, so it's okay for there. But it's not enough. Maybe in some instance in the graph, there will be something where the vertical line will intersect twice. Okay? So if there is something that your vertical line intersects twice in any part of the graph, that will not be a function. So let's try another one. Well, pretty much, it only intersects here once. But let's try it in the right-hand part, in the right part of the graph. So it only intersects once. Intersect once, rather. Well, in fact, if we're going to write a lot of vertical lines in all of these graphs, we will see that the vertical lines, will only intersect the graph only once in all the parts of the graph. Well, with that, it is very clear to us now that this graph, this green graph here, is indeed a function. Okay, so that's a very easy way to know if your graph is a function. Just imagine a vertical line in every part of it, and then there, you're good to go. If it only intersects once in every part of the graph, it's a function. If otherwise, then it's not. Okay, so that ends our video for today. Just a recap. So we have different ways to represent functions. We have used the ordered pairs, the one that we did before. Equations, we will talk about this more on the next topic using our functional notation. and the rest of it, how to evaluate functions and such. Graph, using the vertical line test, there's just the slide before this. The table of values, well, which is pretty much the same with the ordered pairs, and the diagram, of course. So thank you so much. Hope you will try to follow our YouTube channel and subscribe to our Facebook page. It's written here. And hope you get something here. Thank you.